What's up my stylish people, this is Shashank, welcome back to the channel. Today's video, it's not a haul video. In this video, I'm gonna talk about how to take care of your skin during monsoon season where the climate is going to be humid. Also, I will share the tips on how to prevent the body odor. Coming to the tips, what I'm gonna talk about in this video are the ones which includes the facial skin and body skin, also the skin on your feet as well. As you already know that the climate during the monsoon season is humid, it leaves your skin prone to fungal infections, bad odor, and increased sweating, causing the skin to break. And if you're already prone to acne, this may also lead to acne flaring. The tip number one is on the facial skin. During the humid climatic conditions, the skin produces excess oils. So the first thing which you have to do is to take a blotting paper and then you have to wipe the excess oil. In case if you don't have the tissue paper or any blotting paper handy with you, what you have to follow is the periodic cleansing of your face skin. But while doing that, make sure you have two different face washes, one for the morning routine and one for the night routine. Why it is really important to have two face washes? Generally go for the milder option when it comes to the morning. If you have any salicylic acid composition to it, it generally helps in removing the excess oil from the skin. However, when you do that during the daytime, it leaves your skin prone to sunlight. So again, you have to use the sunscreen along with the moisturizers. Better skip that during morning time and include them during your nighttime routine. If your skin is prone to acne, I would highly recommend to go for any face washes which have tea tree composition to it. Coming to the tip number two. Now let's focus on the body skin during the monsoon season. It leaves our body prone to bacterial infections because the skin is going to be damp during the humid conditions. I have two products here to suggest. One, any antibacterial soap, not necessarily that it should be mild, and then a moisture absorbing powder. Once you cleanse your skin and once it has been dried after bath, make sure that you apply a moisture absorbing powder. Tip number three, coming to the body odor, which I mentioned at the start of the video, there is a straightforward solution for it, which you guys maybe knowing by this time. It's applying a perfume. It's not a rocket science that in order to prevent odor you have to apply perfume. Human body have five warmer areas. In case if you don't know, the first one would be the wrist, and the second one would be the neck, third one would be inside the elbows, and fourth one on back of the knees, and fifth warmer area is ankle. These are the pulse points. These are the natural radiators of heat on the human body. So if you spray perfume on top of these areas and it causes the perfume to diffuse its fragrance, and your fragrance will be long lasting. If you want to smell good, this is the tip you have to follow. Coming to the next tip on the body odor, in case if you don't want to use perfumes and if you do not have them handy, the simple tip which you have to include in your hygiene routine is to take shower at least twice a day. Why it is really important? During the humid conditions, the high humidity causes constant sweating and it even doesn't allow the sweat to evaporate. And make sure that you use a loofah if you are using a body wash. If you ask me, I generally use two products. During the humid conditions, if it is humid as well as hot, I go for citrus based products when it comes to the body wash. And if it is humid, when it is cold, I generally go for the Shea options. Loofah, I think it's not too costly. You can get it as low as maybe 99 or 79 rupees in many of the stores, but ensure that you pick a loofah which is not too harsh on your skin. Coming to the tip number five, it's fuzzy free areas. Make sure that your armpits as well as the pubic areas are trimmed and do not have excessive hair because it tends to trap sweat and it leads to body odor. When you are trimming or when you're removing the hair, ensure that you don't use the same blade which you use for the facial skin. Use a separate trimmer, or if you do not have a separate trimmer, make sure that you buy a trimmer which have a different blade to it. If you use the same blade, that will lead to major hygiene issues. It will lead to breakout on your skin because the skin on your face is much more sensitive when it is compared to the skin on your body. Coming to the tip number six, shoes are the breeding ground for the bacteria, and particularly during the humid or monsoon conditions, they tend to get damp and it leads to fungal infections on your feet. If you have talcum powder or any powder handy with you, make sure that you sprinkle the powder into the socks and then you wear it. That not only helps as a lubricant but also prevents your skin from any kind of fungal infections and also absorb any moisture left in the shoes. And the added bonus, It makes your shoes smell good rather than the stinky smell which generally is associated during the monsoon season. And a tip number 7, which I said it is a bonus tip. Make sure that you take a small tub of lukewarm water. You add any antibacterial oil such as neem oil or eucalyptus oil into it and keep your feet for at least 10 to 15 minutes. And trust me, you are not going to get any skin infections, and also the skin on your feet is going to get better. I hope you guys found this video informative on how to take care of your skin and prevent bad body odor during the monsoon seasons. If you did so, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to this channel not to miss out on any content like this in the future. That's it from me. See you guys next time.